Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Global Sports Streaming Presents, brought to you by Paco Presents Boxing. Ready for this four-belt card that we have here? We have an exciting main event. We have Alejandro Santiago, 21-2, versus Willibaldo Garcia, 10-3. In our co-main event, we have Victor Sandoval, 33-3, from Tijuana, versus Kevin Villanueva. So we have an exciting card here. Let me introduce everyone. My name is Chris Martin, and my co-host here for the afternoon, for the evening, excuse me, Dylan El Rey Miranda.
Hey, what's going on, Chris? It's good to be here. We have a lot of good fights on this card, a lot of local talent. Three out of the four fights are fighters from Tijuana. I'm excited to see this fight, especially the main event, going for the Bantam, the WBC Bantamweight International title. This show is, we're going to see fireworks today, Chris.
I'm expecting fireworks as well, Dylan. You know, we have two WBC titles on the line. We have the WBC Bantamweight International title in our main event. In our co-main event, we have the vacant WBC Super Flyweight International title. So, everybody, we have two championship fights for you guys. All in the smaller weights. Nobody here goes above 135. So you know what we're going to see. We're going to see action-packed. We're going to see punches flying. That's typically what we see in the lower weight classes. Right, Dylan?
That's true, man. These guys come out and they throw a bunch of punches.
Punches. it was a little tongue twister there for you, but
hey, it got me. You know what I was saying, man.
Everybody here knows what you were saying. If you're a boxing fan, you know that the lower weight classes, punches in bunches. I'm going to keep saying that for you so you know it for the rest of the night and you don't forget it, Dylan.
Everybody back home, if I don't say it correctly by the end of the night, it's because Chris.
It's because of me. It's the beers that I'm giving him under the table.
No, but yeah, man, these fights, I'm excited to see them. A lot of these guys are actually a friend of mine's.
Growing up from the amateur days?
Yeah, coming up from the amateur days of boxing here in Tijuana. And some of them are actually from my hometown of Guasave, Sinaloa, fighting friends of mine here in Tijuana. So,
man, small world. That's really cool. Guasave, Sinaloa. And that's our co-main event, Kevin Villanueva from Guasave, Sinaloa, fighting Victor Sandoval of Tijuana. So, and that's our co-main event. You got Dylan's, what do we say?
Carnal. Carnal. Just leave it at carnal.
Carnal. All right, man. I like it.
Coming up, we have the first match of the day, Chris. We have flyweights, two undefeated fighters, and Brian Luna, 5-0, and Felipe Ayon, 1-0.
Yeah, and that's a good matchup already. We have two undefeated guys, and me as a manager, I don't know if I'd recommend 1-0 versus 5-0, you know, being the 1-0 fighter. But they have confidence in Felipe Ayon, who you guys see on the screen walking to the ring.
From Ensenada, Baja California, Felipe Ayon. Felipe Ayon, Chris, 1-0 with one knockout. So this, I mean, to me, 1-0 is kind of a mystery still.
Yeah, definitely a mystery. And like I mentioned, his opponent, as you see, Brian Luna, making his way to the ring here. 5-0, three knockouts. I don't know if I'd fight Brian Luna with five fights. no losses. If I'm 1-0, Felipe Ayon, it's a very brave, in my opinion, from his management, from him as well.
That says something about the confidence that his team has on this guy. Now, Brian Luna, 5-0, and from Los Mochis, Sinaloa, so paisano too.
So is it safe to say that your guy for today, or for this fight, is Brian Luna?
It's hard to say, man. It's hard to say. You know what? I can't go against Sinaloa, man. Let's go, Brian. Let's go.
And that's what boxing is about. You know, you pick your guy pretty much off the fact that, he's my countryman. He's from my part of town. You know, that's kind of something that you go by usually.
Damas y caballeros, esta es la tercera llamada. ¡Comenzamos! Y a nombre de Fábrica de Campeones y Paco Presents, esta velada boxística, Noche de Campeones, Noche de Boxeo número 29, desde la frontera más visitada del mundo, Tijuana, Baja California, México. Le damos la bienvenida a todos nuestros aficionados al boxeo que nos siguen a través de las redes sociales de BIB, The Best in Boxing, Fight Club TV en YouTube y GSS, Global Sports Streaming. Este evento es sancionado a ustedes por la Honorable Comisión de Box, Lucha Libre y Artes Marciales Mixtas de esta ciudad de Tijuana. Sanctioned by The Boxing, Pro Wrestling and MMA Commission from Tijuana. President, el presidente Carlos Dabastida. Commissioner, comisionado en turno, Jesús González. Your chief physician in ringside, su jefe de servicios médicos, el doctor Benjamín Sandoval. Your timekeeper, al frente del tiempo, César Fernández. Your three judges scoring this bout in ringside. Sus tres jueces, Julián Palombo, Sergio Lechuga y Francisco Pacheco. And your referee in charge of the action, el referee para este combate, el profesor Fernando Rentería. And now, boxing fans, let's get ready for four rounds of boxing in the flyweight division. Cuatro rounds de combate en la división de peso mosca. Introducing to you first, the fighter standing in the blue corner. He wears blue and gray. He officially weighs in 116 pounds. Presentando ustedes en la esquina azul, con pantaloncillo color azul con gris, con un peso de 52 kilos 700 gramos. He stands with two professional bouts. Cuenta con dos combates profesionales. De la ciudad de Ensenada, Baja California, Felipe Acho. And his opponent across the ring, standing in the red corner, towards black and silver. He officially weighs in 113.5 pounds. Y su rival en esquina roja, vistiendo pantaloncillo color negro con plata, con un peso de 51 kilos 600 gramos. As a professional, he stands with a record, a perfect one. 5 victories, no defeats, and 3 of those victories coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 5 victorias, 0 derrotas, y 3 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. El invicto de Los Mochis, Sinaloa, representando al gimnasio de la familia Girarte de Tijuana, Brian Luna. And to give out the final instructions, your referee in charge. Para las indicaciones finales, su referee, Fernando Rentería. 4 rounds, 4 saltos.
Una pelea limpia, vamos a tener cuidado con los cabezazos, no golpes en la nuca, en la espalda, debajo del cinturón. Hagan una buena pelea, suerte a los dos, choquen sus guantes.
So Chris, let me tell you why I'm a fan of Brian Luna. Not just the fact that he's from Sinaloa like I am. Brian, he was 15-0 in the amateurs. His favorite fighters are Marquez and Lomachenko, which are two of my favorite, you know. So I'm excited to see what this kid's going to do.
Yeah, those are two different styles that he's presenting, that he likes. So let's see what he does here in the ring here tonight.
Starting off strong, right off the bat is Brian.
And right away, throwing to the body and to the head.
Good overhand right.
And there's no feel up moment in the beginning, first round. And that was a good hard left.
Brian Zurdo Luna fighting as a southpaw.
And a good right hook there by Zurdo. That's another. That, these are clean shots landed by both fighters, and not much of a feel-out round is what I was about to say before I got caught up in the moment and became a fan instead of a commentator. Typically, we see a little bit of a feel-out round, especially with guys with five fights and one fight. You know, right away, they're coming in, throwing heavy leather, Dylan.
Oh, yeah, definitely. These guys look like they were fighting in the parking lot, man. They just came in here to continue it. Good uppercut by Zurdo, Luna.
And these are hard shots thrown by both men, Ayon and Luna.
Good jabs by Zurdo, Luna.
And I think Luna kind of decided to sit back a little bit and box a little bit. Maybe it's not, it doesn't suit him. That's a hard left hook by Ayon Lance. A hard right hook by Luna returns. And he seems to be hurt. He has him against the ropes, does Ayon. And he looked hurt, Luna. Dylan.
Yeah, Luna was smiling at us down here, but he definitely looked hurt.
And a hard right hook to the body throws Ayon. And he's being pressured as Luna taking the worst of this exchange.
Yeah, Ayon smelling the blood and the water, Chris.
And Luna doing a good job of defending and landing shots and staying off the ropes.
Yeah, Luna looks fully back into this fight.
It seems as though he has his legs back now, moving side to side, but he definitely was hurt close to 30 seconds ago.
Good body shots by Ayon.
Wow, what a start,
Jesus,
to our fight card here.
And that's just how we're starting, Chris. Jesus Christ. Hey, did I not say there was going to be fireworks?
You absolutely said there was going to be fireworks. And it seems like there was right away in that first round. Luna came very close to maybe chasing the canvas. Felipe Ayon putting on the pressure. And maybe that's something that I talked about at the beginning, that they have confidence in this kid. 1-0, one knockout, fighting a guy with five fights who's undefeated.
Yeah, I was going to touch on that, Chris. Ayon, you know, we were wondering about that. You were saying I would be a little bit hesitant to put somebody at 1-0 versus someone that's 5-0. But, I mean, I think he just shocked both of us with that almost dropping.
Brian Luna, yes, you're
Zurdo
correct.
Luna. Yeah, that's right. Here we go, round two. Zurdo. Zurdo's trying to move around, Chris. Yeah, he's trying to get some
space.
And
now taking initiative, yeah, to box more. Maybe it's something that he was told in the corner that he needs to do more of. He needs to box. He needs to keep his opponent in the distance because we both agree he got hurt in that first round, did Luna?
Yeah, it would benefit him to keep this on the outside. He seems like a smarter fighter, and from what he told me, Marquez, good hook, good left hook.
Yeah,
by Luna.
And in the fighter meeting, he gave us, we asked him for an impression of himself, and he said he's a very technical fighter.
Technical fighter, that's right. And having Marquez and Lomachenko as your favorite fighters, I would expect him to be a little bit more strategic, you know, manage his distance.
As he did not do that in the first round. You know, they went at it, you know, like they didn't like each other. And now he does a better job of boxing on the outside, moving, stepping, throwing that jab.
Ooh, good right hook by Luna.
And he followed up with a good uppercut as well. And it seems as though Ayon is having difficulty with this style of Luna than he did in the first round.
And you know what? I think Luna was just getting started, man, because right now he's boxing really intelligently. He's throwing in combinations and moving. That is what I want to see in somebody with his style. Good movement overall. And it looks like he made the proper adjustments for this round, Chris. Now I'm seeing a little bit of Loma where he's fighting and moving. You see that?
Yeah, he those little side steps. Maybe not entirely a Lomachenko, but taking a little page from his book.
And caught a left hook over there by Ayon.
But he continues to move. Very good head movement, evading all the shots from Ayon.
Some good head movement right there. Good straight left. And good combinations by Sordo.
To the head and to the body. That's what you want to see from a young fighter like Brian Luna. Turned pro at 18 years old, 20 years old now. Only 2 years into his pro career, less than 2 years to be exact. Already with 6 fights, including today.
He's staying busy. Felipe Ayon is doing a good job at keeping the pressure on Zurdo Luna. But right now, the way that Zurdo is cutting off the ring and moving to the side, that was a dominant round by Zurdo Luna.
And a good comeback round because, you know, he was hurt, like we said, in that first round, in our opinion, and he comes back, completely flips it around, and does the right thing. You know, he boxes, he keeps his opponent from not being able to find much, you know, keeps turning him. Something as a coach you would want your boxer to do is to keep turning your opponent so he has no chance to come back and land any shots.
Yeah, he's pivoting, he's turning, he's controlling his opponent. The ability for Zurdo Luna to make those adjustments, being so young and having only 5 fights, is it's impressive, Chris.
It's impressive, and it's telling of what could come of his career. Yeah. You know, Felipe Ayon definitely had his opponent hurt in that first round, but he had trouble in that second round trying to catch Luna.
Let's see if Ayon can figure out the puzzle that Brian Zurdo Luna is putting in front of him.
Yeah, definitely the last 2 rounds up for grabs between the 2 fighters.
And that straight left that Zurdo keeps throwing is landing clutch on Felipe Ayon's face.
And that's typically what you teach your fighter as a southpaw, to throw that left hand down the pipe, correct?
That's right. And Zurdo Luna is doing a fantastic job of keeping his right foot on the outside of Felipe Ayon. Anybody that's boxed against a southpaw knows that foot movement is what you're fighting for when you're in there.
Fighting for positioning, not only with their fist, but with your feet as well.
Yeah, that's right. Good exchanges here. That was a good combination by Zurdo Luna. And even though they're trading, Chris, Zurdo's being more cautious now, keeping his guard up. I believe in the first round, he was going in there overconfident.
Maybe overconfident, you're correct. But he's made the adjustment, he's moving. It's only a 4-round fight, so you can keep those feet moving and maybe not get tired.
Yeah, that's right now what he's doing is, I wouldn't like to see him stay in there because that's what Felipe Ayon wants. He wants him to stay in there and trade. He was doing a fantastic job moving around, hitting, not getting hit. He should go back to doing that after seeing circle out.
Ayon seems to be finding a little Luna a little bit more in this third round. Coming forward, cutting the distance. And Luna
good
with a beautiful sidestep,
man.
And a good combination to finish. As Luna goes to the body, picks it up to the head. And a little combination to the face and continues to turn him Loma style.
Yeah, the turns that he's doing, man, those are, he's doing a great job with it. Only when he stays, you know, in there and starts to exchange with him punch by punch is when he gets caught a little bit. But he keeps moving and boxing intelligently like that.
Yeah, definitely boxing intelligence. And I saw a little bit of frustration in Ayon as he's getting hit and not being able to hit his opponent as he keeps moving.
Yeah, I don't blame him. By the time
good body shot there by Luna, it seemed to have hurt Ayon for a second.
Oh yeah, he lowered his guard.
He lowered his guard a good amount. And Luna feels it.
He's having a field day right now.
He's throwing his shots. He's trying to flurry and close the strong hard.
Ayo needs to bite down on his mouthpiece and finish the round. There we go. Great round by Zurdo Luna, man.
Very good round. Felipe Ayon definitely felt that body shot in the last 30 seconds. Brian Luna capitalized and just emptied out the tank. We have one round left. You know, we talked about the gas tanks in both fighters. But it seems as though Felipe Ayon is bringing a little...
De una manera muy vulgar, me parece a mí políticamente hablando, a los adversarios políticos, incluyendo a los de su propio proyecto político, que son los de Morena, ¿no? Le podemos poner nombres si ustedes quieren, pero no le ha tenido piedad a nadie. Yo creo que en el ejercicio del poder hay que tener cierta humildad. El poder, se dice por ahí en una máxima, se usa, no se dice, ¿no? Tú lo ejerces, pero...
Damas y caballeros, round número 4, el último round. Ladies and gentlemen, this is round number 4, your final round.
As we enter the last round between Brian Luna and Felipe Ayon.
All right, Chris, so we're 3 rounds into this fight. I gave the first round to Felipe Ayon, and the last 2 rounds have been all Zurdo Luna. As he's getting his legs under him, he looks more confident this round.
So either we're going to get a victory for Brian Luna or maybe even a tie from Felipe Ayon if he could muster this round.
But if Felipe Ayon wants to win this round, he needs to start cutting off the ring because he's following him. By the time he's throwing the punches, Soto's on the other side of the ring. He needs to cut it off and put him in the corners like he's doing right now. But Zurdo Luna's doing a good job of turning him and getting out of those corners.
And he may feel like he has the advantage there. He continues to move very strategically there, evading a shot and countering as we see him moving laterally over and over.
And a lot of fighters think walking forward is going to give you points with the judges, but the way that Zurdo Luna is using the ring, that's ring control. He's doing what he wants.
Yeah, a big part of boxing is ring generalship, and right now Brian Luna is controlling the ring with that ring generalship. Moving.
Ooh,
and,
good
and
straight
a hard
left
hand by Luna. It seemed to have staggered his opponent.
He hit him with 2, Chris. Then he follows it up with a body shot.
And it seems like Ayon is on shaky legs as Luna continues to throw his combinations.
Oh.
And a hard left hook landed by Ayon, getting his respect back. But back to the movement, does Luna.
It's those turns, Chris. It's those turns.
And this is boxing, ladies and gentlemen. You young fighters out there, this is what you want to look out for. This is boxing. The way he does it, he throws his shots, he moves laterally, not straight back, making his opponent miss.
Ooh.
Like he just did there.
Like the toreos here in Tijuana. When
the matadors.
Hey, the matadors. Good body shots by Zurdo Luna. And look at that. He's turning him like it's a dance. This is, you know, he's doing his art in there, Chris.
Brilliant stuff from Brian Luna. After having a difficult first round, boxing skills.
Good straight left, and then he takes it to the body.
Beautiful body shot there. Definitely Ayon felt that one.
And he's keeping those jabs out there too, Chris.
What a way to close the last and final round. Both fighters try to muster a win. But it seemed as though Brian Luna may have been a little bit too much for Felipe Ayon, sweeping the last 3 rounds on my scorecard and Dylan's scorecard as well.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it was impressive. The first round, I mean, he got caught with a bad punch. But he was able to make the adjustments, and that's what you look at from a young fighter. This kid is 5-0. The skills that he was showing up here, I mean,
it seems as though he has more experience, right? We didn't really get to talk to him in the fighter meeting regarding
his amateur background, Chris. He had 15 fights with 15 wins.
Oh, that's right. That's right. You did mention that at the beginning of the fight, and 15-0.
15-0, man.
So he's never tasted defeat as an amateur or as a professional.
Yeah.
Very good showing from Brian Luna. If the judges see it any way that we see it, we see him coming out with the victory here, going back to Los Mochis, Sinaloa.
Hey, but you know what? I knew he was going to be good, man. He comes from where I'm coming from. You know, Sinaloa has the best.
Definitely some of the best fighters that coming out of Mexico, you know. Jorge Travieso Arce, former world champion.
That's right.
You can mention a few more.
Julio Cesar Chavez and Julio Chavez Jr. both stay in Culiacán, Sinaloa.
So the state within itself is pretty much what you're going for. So
it's the blood, Chris. It's the blood. It's in the blood.
It's the fighting passion.
Los huevos.
Of the Sinaloenses. I got it.
Man, my heart was still going down, though. I hope everybody at home enjoyed that fight. That was fast-paced right off the bat. No fill-out round at all.
It was a very good way to start the evening of fights. As we take it to Pablo Flores.
Damas y caballeros, después de cuatro rounds de combate, nos vamos con las tarjetas de los jueces. After four rounds of boxing, we now go to the judges' scorecards. Los tres jueces, all three judges, Julián Palombo, Sergio Lechuga, and Francisco Pacheco have the same scores of 40-36. Coinciden en número los tres jueces, 40-36. For your winner by the way of unanimous decision, su ganador por la vía de la decisión unánime, Los Mochis Sinaloa, Brian Luna.
And a unanimous decision for Brian Luna of Los Mochis Sinaloa. So not one judge gave him a round. So not even that first round where you and I, Dylan, thought he was hurt. The judges did not see it that way. Gave every round to Brian Luna. Moves on his professional boxing record to 6-0 and 3 knockouts.
I mean, it's the right winner, Chris. I'd still give the first round to Felipe Ayon, but I'm glad that the right winner won here in Brian Luna. And I look forward to seeing this kid back in the ring, man.
Yeah, definitely a good style, you know, the way he boxed. He came out brawling. It wasn't to his benefit. So what did he do? He turned it, and he boxed. He boxed off the back foot, kept turning his opponent. Because, to be honest, they came out firing, the both of them.
Yeah.
It was very exciting at the beginning.
And I like the style that he has, Chris, because it's not a boring fighter where he's just waiting to counterpunch. He's in your face, man. He's throwing punches. He's just not letting you hit him, man, because he moves around. He's using all the tricks in the book at you.
Yeah, very good stuff, man. High-level boxing from Brian Luna. Went ahead and took over the fight, in our opinion, after losing the first round. Not to the judges, though, but like you mentioned, the right winner won. Despite the scores, the right winner won.
That's right. Now, so we get the ring cleaned up, ready for the next fight.
Nice and sanitized.
The next fight is exciting as well. We have Christian Cruz from Tijuana, Baja California versus Diego Alemán from Playas de Rosarito, Baja California. So Diego Alemán isn't really an outsider. He's just from down the street. Christian Cruz, 12-5 with 6 KOs. Diego Alemán, 12-1 with 8 KOs. This fight's going to be... I really don't see this fight going the distance. It's scheduled for 8 rounds, but I happen to know both of these fighters, and Diego Alemán is coming off an impressive win. Actually, on the Terminator, Pinto, you know, we saw Pinto go through so many punches when he fought Gonzalez, and I was expecting Pinto to go in there and withstand all the punches, go in and make it to the decision. But Diego Alemán, he was able to knock him out, man. I was there for that fight in Rosarito, and I was impressed, man.
Definitely impressive, man. If we saw Pinto on our last telecast, or second to last telecast on Best in Boxing, and that guy can take a shot.
Yeah,
kept
definitely
walking forward. I think we gave him the nickname the Terminator.
The Terminator,
because
that's
kept
Terminator,
coming,
man,
after every shot landed by Giovanni Gonzalez.
Yeah, and Diego Alemán, I happen to know him personally because we competed against each other in the amateurs. He beat me once, and I beat him once. So this kid is a good boxer, man. He's got skills. But so does Christian Cruz, man. I'm excited to see this fight. I don't know who's going to win, but I can tell you one thing.
You don't feel that it's going to go the distance.
It's not going to go the distance,
especially,
man.
Super featherweights, 8 rounds. It seems as though we have just a fantastic card for everybody here at home.
Yeah, right off the bat, man, thank you to Baco Boxing, man. This, like, with the first fight, this is a great card.
Yeah, Baco presents a very good show here for us tonight. I have to mention that he was mentored by the late Mr. Don Chargin, who promoted many of my fights, Chris Martin, the San Diego Kid. Paco Damian was his understudy, and to take such experience from Mr. Don Chargin, Hall of Fame promoter, used to call him Fight a Week, I believe. Fight a Week, or I'm sorry, I can't think of the name, but back in the auditorium in Los Angeles, man, used to put on shows nonstop, you know, once a week.
Right.
Fight a Week, Don.
He actually had the record for the highest paid fight, which was, at the time, Mayweather versus De La Hoya. You know, he wrote the checks, so learning from somebody like that, you know, Paco has some knowledge on him.
Yeah, definitely some knowledge. I mean, you guys saw it with the first fight.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
It was a very good four-round bout, and typically our four-round bouts are just simply to kind of put you into the groove of what's to come, and it was a good matchup, you know, in Felipe Ayon and Brian Luna, so we have some good matchups here for you guys tonight.
As we get the fight started, man, Diego Alemán, like I mentioned, his last fight was in Rosarito. He won by knockout. His favorite fighter is Márquez. Knowing him, he doesn't have a counterpunch style like Márquez had. He has a go forward, in your face, but smart with distance. Not just, you know, some people like to get too close and
smother shot.
And smother themselves. Diego Alemán, like, he keeps the distance in a smart way, and he sets up the power punches.
Diego Alemán.
As we see Diego Alemán make his way to the ring. And Diego Alemán getting familiar with the ring as we see it here. He looks good and warmed up. I don't really like it when I see fighters not sweating. He's coming out sweating, ready to go, warmed up, ready to put on a show is Diego Alemán.
Yeah, I agree with you, because like we saw in the last fight, you have to be ready to go from 0 to 100 right off the bat.
Yeah, not 0 to 60, 0 to 100.
Yeah,
I like that.
And that's why usually the first couple of rounds are slow. Not
Cristian,
here.
El Candoncito Cruz.
We
see Christian Cruz from Tijuana, Baja California, make his way to the ring.
As we see Christian Cruz getting comfortable in the ring himself, we're going to take you to Pablo Flores
for official announcement.
Fábrica de Campeones, Don Charger Productions y Paco Presents presentan este combate pactado a 6 asaltos en la división de peso pluma. 6 rounds of boxing in the featherweight division. Your 3 judges scoring this bout in ringside. Sus 3 jueces, Julián Palombo, Francisco Pacheco y Sergio Lechuga. And your referee in charge of the action, su referee para este combate, el profesor Fernando Rentería. Introducing you to you first, the fighter standing in the blue corner. He wears black and silver. He officially weighs in 128 pounds. Presentando ustedes en la esquina azul, con pantaloncillo en color negro con plata, con un peso de 58 kilos, 200 gramos. He stands with 14 professional bouts. 12 victories, 1 defeat, 1 draw, and 8 of those victories coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 12 victorias, una derrota, un empate y 8 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Representando a Rosarito, Baja California, Diego, el flaco alemán. And his opponent across the ring, standing in the red corner, he wears white and gold. He officially weighs in 129 pounds. Y su rival en la esquina roja, con pantaloncillo color blanco con oro, con un peso de 58 kilos, 700 gramos. In 17 professional bouts, he stands with a record of 12 victories against 5 losses, and 6 of those big wins coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 12 victorias, 5 derrotas, y 6 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Damas y caballeros, la dinastía Cruz continúa. Cristian, el Acandón Cruz. And now to give out the final instructions, para dar las indicaciones finales, su referí, el profesor Fernando Rentería. 8 asaltos, 8 rounds.
Bien, pues adiós aquí un poquito. Vamos haciendo una pelea limpia, jóvenes, ¿ok? Vamos a tener cuidado con los cabezazos, golpes en la nuca, bajo el cinturón, están prohibidos. Choquen su guante, suerte, ganen mejor, cuídense.
As we get ready for our second bout of the evening, super featherweights, 8 rounds. Cristian Cruz of Tijuana, Baja California versus Diego Alemán from Rosarito. These guys probably know each other, right?
They probably do, man.
Very close.
People from Rosarito, from Ensenada, always come here to Tijuana and vice versa.
Get some sparring.
Yeah, it's a fighting state, you know. People from here, they travel everywhere in order to fight. It's crazy. You take a 2-hour taxi to Ensenada just to go throw hands. Now, Cruz, undefeated in his amateur record. I was speaking to him a little bit before the fight. I know both guys, but Cruz, he was telling me, you know, his discipline, he really gets it from his dad. His dad started him off as far as exercise and discipline goes. His favorite fighter is Pac-Man. Pac-Man has a fast pace. Like we said, punches and punches.
Punches and punches.
I got it right. Got it right. So far with these guys, it's a slower pace, Chris. They're both smart fighters.
Well, this is an 8-round bout, so you can't come out firing like we did in the last fight with Brian Luna and Felipe Ayon. Those guys came out and just started throwing.
Although Cruz landing some hard shots on the inside, and I believe, if I'm not mistaken,
and a good jab by Cruz.
Aleman has a little blood on his left eye. So but we have a cut already.
And Cruz taking full advantage of that cut as he lands a hard right to the top of the head of Aleman.
Yeah, Cruz told me he liked that Pacquiao style where he keeps hitting you with a bunch of punches, then he moves out. And I'm seeing it. I'm seeing him replicate it. The damage on the right eye of Aleman already. This fight is scheduled to go 8 rounds, and best
and
believe
a hard
that,
left hook there by Cruz.
Yeah, and you best believe that that eye is going to become a factor.
Definitely
in this fight.
A problem there.
And nonstop action by Cruz, hitting and moving.
And he turned southpaw as he came out orthodox, turned southpaw, maybe trying to confuse his opponent there for a second.
Ooh. Good exchange of punches right there. Diego Aleman, he may have a calmer boxing style, but he has some strong punches. We still have 8 rounds to go.
And Cruz goes back to orthodox, where he had success in the beginning portion of the round, cutting Diego Aleman over the left brow. And we'll see how the corner of Aleman handles a cut so early in the very first round. And definitely a punch, because we did not see any type of head clash or even come near.
Oh yeah, that was definitely a punch, Chris. And a lot of fighters nowadays are coming out with and they're using the side steps. They're turning. They're being smart.
Yeah, you no longer see like Mexican style as in just forward.
Staying
like
in
Chavez
front.
Style, yeah.
Right.
Taking two to give one. None of that. We're seeing a much more boxing style.
We're seeing the evolution of boxing, man.
And that's what it should be. Yeah. Perfect.
I mean, when Lomachenko came in and everybody saw that style and it was so impressive.
Changed the game, absolutely.
Changed the game.
As we begin the second round of Christian Cruz and Diego Aleman. Diego Aleman already with a cut over his left eye.
I expect Aleman to turn it up this round because he can't keep taking damage like that with that left eye already bleeding.
And a good hook there landed by Aleman, getting his opponent's attention.
That's what he needs to do, Chris. He needs to start hitting with some
with
hard
sharp
punches.
Counters, correct.
Good exchange of punches there.
And a good little combination.
Oh, good overhand right.
And Cruz landing a good hook on Aleman as Aleman takes a step back. And after a good feel-out round in the first round, they get busy right here in the second round. But you'd have to think that Diego Aleman has the worst of it as he has a cut. And the blood is starting to leak into his left eye. And Christian Cruz continues to move from orthodox to southpaw.
He's not making it easy for Aleman to adjust to his style. It's smart. It's what he needs to do. He can't let Aleman figure him out.
Aleman, the equal wins, both Christian Cruz and Diego Aleman, 12 victories apiece, but 8 knockouts. Diego Aleman, Christian Cruz, 6 knockouts. So maybe a little bit more pop on Diego Aleman.
Oh, definitely. I don't expect Cruz to stay in there and exchange with him. I'm sure he's already felt a little bit of the power, which is, you know, why he's coming in, throwing, and staying on the outside.
And a good overhand lands on by Cruz, puts his opponent down.
Sobre el rostro de el
And that was a hard overhand right landed by Cruz. We'll see if he tries to come in here and finish. It seemed as though it was a flash knockdown by Cruz. Alemán seems to have his legs under him.
Yeah, I think Cruz was throwing a punch, but he also jumped in, so it might have been...
He got caught with the impact coming in, did Cruz.
Yeah.
Excuse me, did Alemán. And Cruz did a good job of timing him with that hard overhand right. As he continues to switch back and forth, and maybe like you said, keeping his opponent, Diego Alemán, puzzled, not knowing what's coming. And that was a hard right hand that came.
Yeah. It's not easy figuring out where your opponent is coming from when he keeps switching from left to right like that. Very smart boxing by Cruz.
Very smart boxing, and it paid dividends right there in that second round, landing a crushing right overhand right hand by Cruz. Put Diego Alemán down to the canvas, but not out.
Right. Now, Chris, if you were Diego Alemán's corner, what would you be telling him right now?
I would definitely tell him, move your head, because for Christian Cruz to simply find him the way he did, it just meant that there's no head movement from Alemán. He just came straight in. It was perfect timing from Christian Cruz. Move your head. Try to guess your opponent, make your opponent guess where you're going to be.
Yeah, Diego Alemán having that Mexican style, coming forward with those hard punches.
As we see the jab, maybe a little bit more technical of a round here between Christian Cruz and Diego Alemán after we got treated to a brawl in the second round.
Yeah, the first two rounds were fast-paced. Now, like we mentioned, this is an eight-round fight, so we're seeing the rhythm slow down a little bit, but it's getting smarter, man. Now they know each other.
And Cruz goes back to the southpaw style, continuing to puzzle his opponent, Diego Alemán.
And you see Diego when he...
Oh, and a hard shot landed there by Cruz. Alemán takes it and keeps charging forward.
Everybody at home, you see that foot position, the lead foot for each fighter. Cruz switches to southpaw, they're fighting for it. You see Alemán throw hard punches when he gets his lead foot on the outside of Cruz's.
And that's typically what happens is they play with each other's feet right there and kind of throw somebody off balance. And continued pressure from Diego Alemán. Christian Cruz doing a very good job of evading shots and punching.
Cruz hitting and then circling out.
Maybe frustrating Diego Alemán a little bit. And a good body shot there by Alemán. Good return from Cruz to the top of the head.
Ooh. See, when Cruz stays on the inside with Diego, that's when he's in trouble.
Yeah, it's more beneficial for Cruz to continue to move laterally.
He's doing a good job at it, Chris. He needs to keep that up. Diego Alemán, we've already seen that he doesn't have much of the waist movement, much of the head movement. What he does have is tremendous punching power. So Cruz definitely needs to stay away from the inside game.
And you can see he has the confidence to just sit there and throw his shots to Diego Alemán. You're right, Christian Cruz needs to keep moving that head. And a good left hand landed by Alemán. It seemed to have buzzed Cruz, but the round is over and he gets a little rest here.
Yeah, you know what, Chris? That is, it's a preview of what can happen if he keeps fighting on the inside with Diego Alemán. Cruz is doing a fantastic job on the outside. He's hitting, he's moving, he's boxing how you're supposed to box. Hit, not get hit. He needs to continue doing that. Now, Diego Alemán.
Yeah, definitely not what you're supposed to do is stand in front of him.
Yeah, Diego Alemán, he has that strong punch. As we get the round started, Chris, we're going to see if Cruz can keep using the smart boxing with moving around like that, or if Diego Alemán can circle him in, you know, keep him from moving and land those hard punches. The matchup, Chris. This is a boxer versus a fajador. You know, he's coming in there with the Mexican style with the hard punches.
Yeah, boxer versus puncher. Classic style in boxing matchup. Thank you to Paco Presents, and thank you to Global Sports Streaming for the quality matchups here today. As we see that Alemán may be on shaky legs and the blood is starting to trickle, Christian Cruz seems to have found his spot and pressuring punches in bunches. As Diego Alemán holds for dear life. And more blood coming from the face of Diego Alemán. Maybe Christian Cruz smelling the blood. And that's why he threw those punches, that flurry of shots, that he was successful there.
I mean, like we mentioned in previous fights, Chris, I mean, you try to target that eye to get the doctor involved. You can win right off from that, from technical knockout.
Yeah, make it a fast night. Pretty much what every boxer aspires for. You don't want to stay in there for all 8 rounds, all 10 rounds, 12 rounds, whatever you're scheduled for. You want to get out of there. Force the ref to step in, especially when there's a cut already. Get the doctor to look at it. A good right uppercut landed by Alemán. Christian Cruz with a good hook on the inside, turns back to southpaw, and then starts to box again, keep him on distance.
Yeah, Diego Alemán has hard punches, but he needs to throw them in combinations. I believe he's throwing them one at a time.
Yeah, definitely pop-shotting Christian Cruz.
He needs to get that jab involved too, Chris. He doesn't have much of a jab.
Well, so far it seems to have worked for him, but you're correct. You know, he would like to see more. His corner would like to see more output, considering he's having success with that one shot, two shots.
Then we start seeing some double jabs there.
But like you mentioned, the power of Diego Alemán maybe making Christian Cruz a little bit hesitant to let go of that combination.
That's the thing, Chris. This reminds me of the fight between Pinto and Gonzalez, where we saw Gonzalez throw multiple punches.
And a good right hand landed by Cruz. He might hurt his opponent now. Diego Alemán holds again for dear life. And again, saved by the bell. So, man. 2 rounds in a row, Christian Cruz hurts his opponent, and the bell saves Diego Alemán.
Yeah, Cruz is having...
As we come back from an exciting finish to a 4th round again, Christian Cruz puts his opponent, Diego Alemán, in danger once again to close the round as he did in the 3rd. He does it again in the 4th. We'll see how he comes out for the 5th round.
We start seeing the jabs of Diego Alemán. Oh, and a good straight right by Diego Alemán.
And Diego Alemán just tough and keeps coming forward. Despite being hurt two rounds in a row to finish the rounds, comes out strong.
You know, a quick fun fact of Diego Alemán, he actually fought the Terminator, Pinto, and beat him by knockout. Oh! And he gets dropped.
No pasa nada. No pasa nada.
He gets dropped by Cruz.
No pasa nada, güey. No pasa nada, güey. No pasa nada.
As he tries to finish, does Cruz putting on the pressure.
They were still on shaky legs.
Definitely still on shaky legs. Overhand right landed by Cruz.
Can he survive this round?
And it doesn't seem as he could survive. Still on shaky legs is Alemán. Christian Cruz.
Still a minute and a half left in the round.
Putting his shots together. And Alemán still there. Still tough.
Still there, still tough. And Cruz has to be smart to not, you know, throw everything out right now.
Put himself in danger. You're correct, Dylan.
You run out of fuel in this round and you can come back. Good inside work. They decided to tie it up. And a touch hands. You see that blood dripping from Diego's left eye.
And Christian Cruz doing a very good job of evading the shots of Diego Alemán, moving. Good boxing skill. And turns to southpaw again and lands a hard left to the face of Diego Alemán.
Boxer versus puncher, Chris. Who do you choose? Ooh, and a good left hook by Cruz.
And Cruz seems to have his opponent again hurt in the final 10 seconds. Diego Alemán surviving in the last 10 seconds. And it seems to be the tail of the tape here for the past three rounds. Diego Alemán hurt by Christian Cruz to close each and every round.
And you know what? Cruz is smelling the blood, Chris.
Yeah, he definitely smelled blood. Came hard in the closing seconds of that final round there, of the fifth and final round. Excuse me. I'm just a bit excited. Very good shots. And for the third time in a row, Diego Alemán close to going down. Christian Cruz smelling blood three rounds in a row. 5-4-3 as we start the sixth round of a scheduled eight-round bout between Christian Cruz and Diego Alemán.
Cruz so far having a showcase of skill here. Hitting, moving. He mentioned to me that his favorite fighter was Pacquiao. And I see why, man. He switches to southpaw.
Yeah, he does try to emulate the style and the way he moves. And, yeah, turning to southpaw, him being a right-handed himself.
Yeah, jumps in, hits, moves, using the whole ring. Now, Diego's following him, but he needs to close off the ring instead of following him.
And a good jab there to the body landed by Cruz. And I always say, you jab to the body to freeze your opponent. It's not the most hurtful punch, but you freeze your opponent, and he lands a hard right hook there to Cruz. But still does not stop Diego Alemán from just walking forward. Kind of like that Terminator style that we've seen before in Best in Boxing, Global Sports Streaming.
And like I mentioned before, he fought and beat the Terminator. So this is Terminator 2.0. And you see Diego Alemán loading up on that right hand, but he's not setting it up.
And beautiful boxing there. Showcased by Christian Cruz. Dipping and dodging and returning.
Reminds me of the dodgeball movie.
If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. In this case, a punch. I got you.
Yeah, that's right.
Good movement by Christian Cruz.
Good exchanges here. Diego's throwing those tough, hard punches, Chris. If he needs to mix in a couple of light, fast punches. You know what I'm saying? He needs to set up those hard punches.
Yeah, maybe a little bit more setup. He definitely is throwing a lot of heat as he's hurt his opponent and sent his opponent to the canvas twice.
You know what? Cruz is being smart because when he does end up on the inside, he either hugs or hits and moves. And that's what you should do.
And for the first time in after three rounds in a row, Christian Cruz does not hurt Diego Alemán. They exchange shots to close the round as we go into the seventh round. Diego Alemán seeming to be breathing heavily in the corner.
The story so far.
Yeah, can you hear me? As we come back, we see Christian Cruz getting ready for the seventh round. And we continue to see Diego Alemán, trying to press forward as we get a quick break in the action. Gotta fix the trunks of Diego Alemán. Maybe too much cojones
could be
for Alemán.
You see a retaping of the glove.
So who would benefit from this little break or longer break? Would it be Christian Cruz or Diego Alemán? Who do you think, Dylan?
I think Cruz would benefit because he's the one moving around the most. He's jumping in, he's throwing the punches, he's the one staying active. So it does benefit Cruz.
Maybe Cruz, yeah, and maybe he can muster a surge, explosive shots. He's been able to hurt his opponent three times.
This is the final round, so Alemán
putting Tijuana on the map.
I agree, Chris. That was a showcase of skills. Very, the whole eight rounds, man.
Very good showcase of skills. Never got tired. Continued to move. Continued to punch. Never let his opponent, Diego Alemán, into the fight. Cut him in the very first round and never let up. Just continued to just put the pressure with punches and movement. Solid performance by Christian Cruz.
Impressive work.
Very impressive work. Very good movement. You know, and see what we come to see of Christian Cruz in the super featherweight division, as we have very good fighters, very good champions at 130 pounds, super featherweight. obviously that's a goal of every fighter. Christian Cruz, if we have it correctly, moves to 13 victories. If the judges see it the way we see it.
It would be tough for them not to. I mean, he hurt Aleman multiple times early on and continued hitting, moving, scoring points throughout the whole eight rounds.
Dropped his opponent, cut his opponent. It'd be very hard not to see a unanimous victory from Christian Cruz, the native of Tijuana. As we bring it up for our official decision to Pablo Flores.
Damas y caballeros, este combate ha sido a la distancia de 8 rounds. Por lo tanto, nos vamos con la decisión de los jueces. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout has gone the distance of 8 rounds, and now we go to the judges' scorecards. El juez, Judge Julián Palombo, he scores it 80-70, 80-70. Sergio Lechuga, he has the scores of 78-72, 78-72. And Francisco Pacheco, he scores it 79-71, 79-71. For your winner, by the way, of unanimous decision, su vencedor por la vía de la decisión unánime. La dinastía Cruz presente, Cristian El Acandón Cruz.
And as we had it, Dylan, unanimous decision from Cristian Cruz, putting on a brilliant boxing exhibition over Diego Alemán of Rosarito, Mexico.
I mean, yeah, it would have been difficult not to have a unanimous decision for Christian Cruz. He stayed busy throughout the whole fight, like we mentioned. He dropped Diego Alemán early on. Like you said it, he cruised to that victory.
Enjoying the puns right away. Pa-pa-boom.
Yeah. Let's put a limit on that. Yeah.
we're gonna request a drum set or a thimble. Is that what they're called? I'm not a musician.
I request you get muted. Production, please.
A special request from Dylan El Rey Miranda, hitting the mute button for Chris Martin.
So far, we're two fights in, and neither fight was boring, man.
Yeah, both
action
fights.
Action packed right off the bat.
Both fights very exciting. Both fights, you know, competitive, up to a point. Diego Alemán showed toughness and grit, but Christian Cruz started to just go away with a unanimous victory early on.
And this is a relatively small card, Chris. It's only four fights, but if the two remaining fights are anything close to the last two fights that we saw, it's well worth it. It's way more than worth it, man. It's economical even.
Absolutely. You know, this is a good card. You know, the first two bouts, four rounds, eight rounds respectively. Now we head to two championship 10 round fights, as we see Kevin Villanueva on the screen. Got 20 years old.
De Guasave, Sinaloa, Mexico. That's my hometown, so you know, I'm rooting for the kid, but he's going against Victor Sandoval from Tijuana, Baja California, who's also a buddy of mine. My heart is torn.
It's
here,
torn. Yeah, I can see that.
Hey, but I do know one thing.
It's gonna be a good fight.
It's gonna be a good fight, man. Yeah. I'm excited for this. As we see El Desbalagado.
And how would you translate that to English for El Desbalagado?
Desbalagado, I mean, that's a tough one. I would say a bad kid, you know, a rascal.
A rascal, I like it.
Kevin the Rascal. Villanueva.
as we see the tell of the tape, 23 years old for Victor Chucky Sandoval, 33-3 with a very good record. Close, maybe close to a world title contention. 33 victories, 21 by the way of knockout. And that's saying a lot for a fighter of that weight. 115 pounds with that KO percentage. It's rare, guys. It's rare, ladies and gentlemen, to see such power from the lighter weights. And two fighters with very good KO percentages are you guys going to see here in our co-main event for the vacant WBC Super Flyweight International title between Victor Sandoval and Kevin Villanueva.
Yeah, and Victor Sandoval has stayed busy throughout his whole boxing career. I know this kid since I was boxing in the amateurs here in Tijuana. And he stays busy. He stays busy right off the bat. Now, Victor Chucky Sandoval, his favorite fighter, I believe, was... he told me once, man. I can't remember.
And we're both drawing a blank here for the favorite fighter of Victor Sandoval, right?
Yeah, but you know what? I've seen this kid fight before, and speaking with him, he told me what I already knew. He's a fajador, which means he goes in there, he's in your face, he has that Mexican style of putting pressure and landing those hard punches. But he doesn't just walk forward on you. He has smart pressure. So we may see a little bit of Cruz in Victor with the movements, the lateral movements, the in and outs.
Okay. He described himself as a counter puncher. He knows his opponent is strong and comes forward in Kevin Villanueva. And that's the style that Villanueva describes himself as an aggressive guy, comes forward strong. You know, so we're in for a good technical fight between the boxer and the puncher. As we see Kevin Villanueva on the screen, well, no more now, you see him at a distance.
They're fighting for this, the WBC International Super Flyweight title. This fight going 10 rounds.
And like I mentioned, a good KO percentage for both fighters. Out of 16 victories, you have 12 by knockout for Kevin Villanueva. Strong puncher for such a small guy.
Oh yeah, this fight has the possibility of ending early, but these are flyweights. You know, they usually do go the distance. It's unusual, like you said, to have two fighters with this percentage of knockouts.
Yeah, two small guys with good knockout percentage. We're gonna see if fireworks here, I imagine, in the first round.
As we see the ref in the ring, the ref is wearing boxing shoes because the way the fights have been going, man, you need to have boxing shoes.
You have to have
anytime.
Boxing shoes, yeah.
It was Aves Sinaloa, Kevin Villanueva.
As we see Kevin Villanueva on your screen making his way to the ring, sporting the 2020 style with a face mask. Kevin Villanueva sporting a record of 16-2-3. 12 by knockout from Guasave, Sinaloa. A place where Dylan El Rey Miranda is very familiar with. As we see Victor Sandoval here on our screen, making his way to the ring.
Chucky Sandoval. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your co-main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC International Silver Flyweight Championship. Damas y caballeros, este es el combate coestelar de esta noche. 10 rounds por el campeonato vacante internacional plata del CMB de los pesos mosca. Presentado a ustedes por Fábrica de Campeones. In association with Don Charging Productions. Empaco Presents. Sanctioned by the WBC President, sancionado por el CMB Presidente Mauricio Sulaimán. Supervisor in attendance, el supervisor Carlos Labastida. Your three judges scoring this bout in ringside. Sus tres jueces, Julián Palombo, Sergio Lechuga y Jesús González. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge, su referee para este combate, profesor Fernando Rentería. Introducing to you first, the fighter standing in the blue corner. He wears black and gold. He officially weighs in 115 pounds. Presentado a ustedes en la esquina azul, vistiendo pantaloncillo de color negro con oro, con un peso de 52 kilogramos. In 21 professional bouts, he stands with 16 victories against 2 losses, 3 draws, and 12 of those big wins coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 16 victorias, 2 derrotas, 3 empates, y 12 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. De Guasave, Sinaloa. Kevin, el desbalagado Villanueva. And his opponent across the ring, standing in the red corner. He wears blue and silver. He officially weighs in 115 pounds. Y su rival en la esquina roja, vistiendo pantaloncillo color azul con plata, con un peso de 51 kilos, 800 gramos. In 36 professional bouts, he stands with a record of 33 victories against 3 losses, and 21 of those wins coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 33 victorias, 3 derrotas, y 21 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Damas y caballeros, representando a su natal Tijuana, Baja California. Víctor El Chucky Sandoval. And now with the final instructions, your referee in charge. Para dar las indicaciones finales, su referee, Fernando Rentería. 10 rounds, 10 asaltos.
Listo, jóvenes, vamos a hacer una pelea limpia, ¿ok? Vamos a tener cuidado con los cabezazos, golpes en la nuca, en la espalda, están prohibidos. ¿Sí? Vamos a hacer una pelea bonita. Choca su guante, suerte, gane mejor.
Ahí las instrucciones del tercero sobre la superficie. A 10 episodios esta pelea por el vacante título planta Super Mosca del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo.
And here we go for our co-main event of the WBC Super Flyweight International title. 10 rounds between Victor Chucky Sandoval, Kevin Villanueva of Guasave, Sinaloa, Dylan Miranda's paisano.
But off the bat, we see Victor Sandoval using the ring more than Kevin Villanueva. Kevin Villanueva was coming in forward, putting on pressure.
Yeah, so we spoke to Victor Sandoval, and he knows his opponent is strong and comes forward. He's looking at counterpunch here tonight. One aspect of his game that he said he wanted to do, counterpunch.
That was a good right hand by Villanueva.
And one of Victor Sandoval's fighters that he looks up to is Juan Manuel Marquez. How technical he is, and he describes himself as that, as a technical and an intelligent fighter. And we're seeing that right off the bat with a hard left hook landed there by Sandoval on the chin of Villanueva. And maybe woke him up a little bit, knows he can't come straight in the way he just did.
Yeah, like we mentioned before, both these guys have a good knockout percentage.
And a good 1-2 with that right hand heading south to the body of Villanueva. And a hard left uppercut there by Villanueva, by Sandoval on Villanueva. And not much offense yet from Kevin Villanueva. Maybe studying his opponent or a bit puzzled is Villanueva from the skills of Sandoval.
I was going to mention, he doesn't seem to have much waist movement or head movement, but right when I was going
to
say
he starts to get into the
groove. Oh, and a good right hand.
And back to the jabs on the wide. So after landing that hard right hand, does not stay there for his opponent, uses his jab, continues to move laterally. And now I see the comparison that he likes to bring up of himself to Juan Manuel Marquez. Fighting strong off that back foot is Sandoval, landing hard shots on the face of Villanueva.
And he's using feints, Chris. He's studying his opponent, too. He's staying busy, but he's studying his opponent.
And good heading to the top and back to the bottom. And Villanueva still has yet to mount in much of an offense as Sandoval picks to the body and lifts it to the head. And a good way to close the round for Sandoval. Pretty much doing what he wanted in that first round.
I agree. Now, Kevin Villanueva, his trainer is the head trainer for the Baja California selection.
So what you're saying is he has good experience there with many up-and-coming fighters, so maybe he should give them good instruction here. As we bring in the second round of a scheduled 10-rounder, WBC Super Flyweight International title on the line, with brilliant boxing skills shown by Victor Sandoval in that first round.
Kevin Villanueva coming in with that heat this round.
Oh! And he gets hit hard with the Sandoval. Oh. And another counter hook there by Sandoval, landing on the head of Villanueva.
And a good overhand right hand
by Villanueva. I was about to say, it doesn't seem to faze the shots that he's taking by Sandoval as he smirks as he comes forward. He may know something that we don't. He may be feeling stronger than Sandoval does Villanueva.
The thing is, Chucky Sandoval is throwing multiple punches. He's throwing combinations. While Villanueva is throwing one hard punch. He needs to set those punches up.
Yeah, he definitely needs to throw more than one shot. But the one shot that he landed seemed to have got Sandoval's attention. I'm not going to say he hurt him, but he definitely got his attention.
Yeah, I'm sure he's a hard puncher, man. But if he sets those up, he could end the night. And start using his jab too. You see Sandoval throwing his jab out there, and as Villanueva tries to load up the right hand.
Yeah, Villanueva's not doing much to close the distance between just burying his head in the chest of Sandoval. And it has yet to pay off, but maybe it will in a 10-round bout.
You see him try to throw that jab, but it's real lazy. It's with no intent of landing that jab.
Very lazy jab, you're correct. And Sandoval has a very good educated jab and very good lateral movement as he lands a hard body shot to Villanueva's sternum.
And with that jab of Chucky Sandoval, he's controlling the distance. The jab for Sandoval is not only stopping Villanueva when he tries to come in, but it's marking the distance.
And good counters to the body. Sandoval keeps throwing that, and that's what you want to see.
So far, smart boxing by Chucky Sandoval as we see the overhand right of Villanueva.
And a good overhand right by Villanueva. And see if he can capitalize on this shot that got his opponent's attention. Takes it to the body. Oh, and a hard left hook by Sandoval. Villanueva has a beard on him. Did not even buckle after Sandoval landed a hard hook to the head and continues to come forward. And a good way to close the round. Both fighters throwing back and forth action from Victor Sandoval and Kevin Villanueva.
That was a great round. It was a great round. I mean,
there's not much to say.
Yeah, Villanueva started.
As we return for the third round of the co-main event, as we close a very exciting exchange between Victor Sandoval and Kevin Villanueva in the second round, see if they start where they left off.
And it looks like they are, Chris, right off the bat.
Oh! And hard exchange from both fighters. With a good jab and trying to keep his distance in Sandoval, but Villanueva not taking no for an answer, continuing to charge forward. And we continue to say, what a beard on Villanueva, just taking the shots.
He's able to take the shots, Chris, but I don't want him to.
Oh, and a hard right hand by Sandoval. And he continues to take it. Doesn't seem to phase Sandoval. Seems to make him more angry.
Oh, and a good body shot by Villanueva. And you know what, Chris? This fight is going 10 rounds. Villanueva needs to start investing.
And a good hard right hand by Sandoval again. Villanueva showing his beard and returning the shots. Continuing to walk forward, now using a little bit of the head movement that we did not see at the beginning of the round.
Yeah, Villanueva needs to invest into the body of Sandoval.
As he did right there, you're correct.
And Sandoval, not much jumping in and out like he was, you know, maybe those body shots are doing some work. Good overhand right by Villanueva.
And Villanueva becoming more and more aggressive.
And it's because Chucky is staying there and he's exchanging with him.
He is exchanging with him now, getting maybe a little bit more brave or just running out of gas. We're yet to see it.
Yeah. Because he had success the past two rounds. That might give him
boxing.
A little bit of slip.
Yeah. Feet tied up there. Sandoval was not hurt. Continues to throw combinations to the head and to the body. Stiff jab there. But to no avail for Villanueva. Not taking a no for an answer. Lands a hard
short hook, and it seems as he got the better of the encounter there against Sandoval.
We're seeing a boxer versus a slugger here, Chris, a puncher.
Yeah, and that round just flew by as Villanueva charged forward the entire round. Sandoval did not do the exact same damage as he did in the first two rounds. And maybe I give that round to Villanueva.
Yeah, we're starting to see a turn here. It might be, well, Victor Sandoval was busy throughout the whole two rounds. You know, and that does take a little bit on you. And I'm sure the body shots that Villanueva is investing in him right now. And I say investing because they start to add up as the rounds go on. Might be taking a some damage on Chucky.
Yeah. As we saw a slight turn in the last round, Kevin Villanueva had a little bit more success with that pressure style that he invokes on Victor Sandoval. See if Victor Sandoval continues to use his movement like he had success in the first two rounds.
That's the blueprint for Chucky Sandoval on this one. Keep moving, keep being smart the way he was the first two rounds, and not stand there and exchange with Villanueva, who we know has a strong punch from the previous round.
He has a strong punch and a strong chin, as he's already displayed, because Victor Sandoval hit him with everything but the kitchen sink, and Villanueva keeps charging forward. Sometimes with no head movement, just walking his opponent down.
Yeah, when you got a chin, you got a chance, a chin, and you know it, you know?
Yeah, good jabs landed there by Sandoval, trying to keep his opponent off balance.
As we see what we had seen the previous rounds, Chucky Sandoval being smart, hitting, moving, using the full range of the ring. Villanueva needs to start cutting off the ring from Sandoval, and he needs to invest in the body of Sandoval to keep him from moving around like that.
But still, Sandoval doing a good job this round, keeping his opponent off balance. Villanueva doesn't seem to have the same momentum. As we see Sandoval charge forward for the first time maybe in the fight, trying to push his opponent back. No longer using his lateral movement, good head movement. See if this might be a mistake going into the jaws of the lion is Sandoval.
Speaking with Sandoval in the locker room, he told me he was a pressure fighter. He likes Juanma, he can counterpunch. But he was going to put smart pressure when he needs to.
When he needs to. So maybe right there we saw a little bit of it. But now he goes back to his back foot, throwing good jabs to the face of his opponent.
And I like the way he put it, smart pressure. Because he is putting pressure like we see now. But he takes a step back, as you should. You should hit and then move.
Yeah, he's a good, intelligent boxer as he lands a hard left hook to Sandoval. And a good 1-2 by Villanueva, closing the round as we approach the last 10 seconds. And a hard body shot by Sandoval there. Doesn't seem to face Villanueva whatsoever. Beautiful close to the fourth round of this fight. As we see Villanueva
Ahí está el tercero sobre la superficie llamando a los dos.
And we see both fighters, Victor Sandoval, Kevin Villanueva, getting ready for the fifth round. Co-main event of the evening, WBC Super Flyweight International title on the line. Both fighters definitely want to add that to their trophy case. And good exchange there from both fighters. Victor Sandoval continuing to use his lateral movement.
He's staying in Villanueva's face. He's keeping his punches in his face. He's just not staying there to receive punches. Yeah, that's what you like to see.
Yeah, very smart fighter. Very good fighter. And maybe a little bit of frustration there from Villanueva, having his back foot come forward. Not too much style there. But starting to pick up the punch count is Villanueva.
He's starting to pick up the punch count. What I want to see him do is close off the ring, because Chaki Sandoval is using the full extent of the ring, and he's doing it beautifully. Now, Villanueva needs to cut that off.
Yeah, excellent. Ring generalship with the hard overhand right by Villanueva there. Gets his opponent's attention. And Chucky Sandoval back to his boxing skills, back to his boxing, back to his jab. And I'm not going to call it a bicycle because he's using lateral movement.
Good body shots by Villanueva.
Ladies and gentlemen, according to the preliminary scorecards by the WBC, these are the scores. Judge A, 39-37. Judge B, 42-36. And Judge C, 39-37. All in favor? Todos a favor de Sandoval.
So maybe a slight advantage, the fact that Victor Sandoval can hear, the fact that he's well ahead on all three judges' scorecards, and that's a rule of any WBC title fight, where we hear the scores after the fourth and eighth round. So Victor Sandoval ahead in all three judges' scorecards.
And he knows it. So what he has to do is he has to hear that, and he has to get the confidence from it, but not get too overconfident.
Not to get too overconfident, but you know that what you're doing is working. So most likely we will see the same from Victor Sandoval and not necessarily change his game plan. Now, does Kevin Villanueva change his game plan? What does he do?
I mean, it might work out for Kevin as well, because it says, hey, I'm losing, I need to step it up, you know? So it might bring a fire to his soul here. We're fighting for a title.
Halfway through a championship 10-round super flyweight bout.
And like I told you guys before this fight started, you guys at home are going to win this fight.
Yeah, this is definitely a good fight so far, as we see Victor Sandoval in the corner. And they're asking to get his opponent in distance. Keep his distance is what they're asking of Victor Sandoval. As we go to the corner of Kevin Villanueva. They're asking for more urgency. They're now asking for a knockout. They are saying he needs to knock his opponent out. He's down half the fight. So the truth is, they're being truthful.
Hey, yeah, and that's what you have to do when you're fighting for a world title. You need to tell your fighter the truth. International title, I'm sorry about that. But any championship, any fight that you're losing, you want to know, man.
Yeah, you definitely want to know. You don't want to get lied to in the corner, feeling that you're doing the correct work, and it turns out that you're not after you go back and look for it. and maybe a little bit more urgency, better technique, and a hard left hook by Sandoval, still unable to get Villanueva off of him.
And we see Villanueva put him in the corner. That's what he needs to do. He needs to put him in the corner and hit him with the hard shots.
And I saw a little headbutt from Villanueva on the chin of Sandoval. And Villanueva doing exactly what his corner asked of him. He's charging forward, trying to get that knockout. You see it here. And it's making it harder for Sandoval to move. And it made those shots because now we see some urgency as a hard right hand landed by Villanueva there.
Yeah, we see Villanueva putting on the pressure. He definitely listened to his corner. And what happens, too, when you get hit hard, you know, it could make Sandoval mad, and then you want to trade with your opponent, you know?
Yeah, definitely. You want it back.
Yeah, you want it back.
As a fighter, you get hit, and you say, F it, I want this back.
Yeah.
And a hard right hand by Sandoval.
Good left hook by Sandoval right now.
But Villanueva keeps coming. It seems as that fire that his corner tried to ignite is coming to fruition. Villanueva is charging forward, landing hard shots.
Good jab by Villanueva. Even with the jab by Villanueva, he needs to keep that jab active. I was asking for that jab.
And Sandoval seems to be a bit weary as Villanueva is charging forward with a little bit more urgency.
It looks like Villanueva got that second win. And he's listening to his corner.
He's definitely listening to his corner that he needs to knock out his opponent. Sandoval's game. Oh, and a
good body shot
by Villanueva. Sandoval tries to return it.
We hear the corner of Sandoval telling him, don't stay there. Like we said, sometimes you get hit and you want to hit your opponent back.
And you want to return.
As we see Villanueva come back into this fight.
Villanueva did come back into the fight. That was a very good round by him. As we begin the seventh round of a highly contested bout between Victor Sandoval and Kevin Villanueva. Kevin Villanueva in that last round took the advice of his corner and attacked, because he knows he's behind.
Yeah, I think Sandoval got the same advice in his corner. Hey, you can't let this kid come back into the fight, so you need to step it up.
And as we mentioned, that he likes to box and he likes to brawl, and he's doing a little bit of both, is Victor Chucky Sandoval. And a hard left hook by Sandoval. Villanueva took it well as he continues forward.
Oh, good.
Landing that 1-2.
Oh, good body work by Villanueva. That's what he needs to do because Sandoval keeps moving.
Wow, what a right hand connected by Sandoval. And a good left hook by Villanueva there, pushing his opponent back. And continue to say that Villanueva doing the work that is requested by his corner, attacking there to the body, and a hard 1-2 landed there by Villanueva, continuing to press forward. And a good jab by Sandoval. And Sandoval sitting there with Villanueva. Maybe not something that his corner would like him to do, considering he's winning the outside game by far.
Yeah, he gets into trouble when he starts standing there with Villanueva, which is what Villanueva wants.
Yeah, maybe after so much pressure, you know, it's hard to be on your back foot the whole time for Sandoval.
Oh, no doubt.
Good right hand by Villanueva there. Returned by Sandoval. And another overhand right by Villanueva. Good uppercut by Sandoval. And they're both exchanging in the middle of the ring. As Villanueva pushes his opponent back.
Oh, and a good uppercut by Villanueva.
And Sandoval is just a tough and grittiness.
Chris, Villanueva is back in the fight. He fought his way back into this fight.
As you're correct. In my card, it's 4-3. So Villanueva, on my card, this is the unofficial card. Villanueva can come to a draw. He gets a knockdown. He may come to a victory. And it seems as though Victor Sandoval is wearing down. Even though he's still throwing good shots, continues to move.
And we're going on to the eighth round, where I believe the WBC announces the scorecard after the eighth round.
And both corners leading with their fighters more and more and more, but it's not that easy for both fighters.
I like the advice that Villanueva's corner gave him was, Take it to the body after you hit the head. Head, body.
And Sandoval picking at the body, trying to keep his opponent off him. And the good head movement by Sandoval there. Brilliant boxing by Sandoval. And reminder that the corner of Villanueva sent him for a knockout. Sent him, hey, go out there and get the knockout. So maybe not, we're not going to see the most technique from Villanueva, but he's moving his head here, side to side.
He's doing good work. He's putting on pressure like his corner wants, but he's doing it without being reckless.
Yeah. Well, I see Victor Sandoval. Yeah, not getting reckless, but I see Victor Sandoval outboxing him here in the first minute of this round. Good jab there landed by Sandoval.
Can't take anything away from Sandoval. He's a smart boxer. You see the waist movement right there by Sandoval.
Ooh, and a hard uppercut landed there by Sandoval.
Sandoval keeping his guard a bit low.
A bit low, you're correct, but I think
but
it
the
makes,
way he's moving
I, it makes up the fact that he's moving so well. Uses his feet very well, uses his head movement very well. Hasn't really got hit with a shot where you say, you know what, he should do something different. Good right hand by Sandoval.
Villanueva continues to dig at that body of Sandoval.
But it seems as though Sandoval is taking that momentum back in the way he started the fight. Moving his head, evading shots.
Oh, good right hand by Villanueva.
Villanueva lands a right hand, getting the attention of Sandoval. And a hard 1-2 by Sandoval. And again. And Villanueva winging, maybe a little, getting a little frustrated with a hard left hook. Landed by Villanueva. And Sandoval lands a hard right hand to counter. For the first time, it seems as though Villanueva is hurt.
He smells the blood. He
taking
smells the blood,
a step
Chris.
Back. And Sandoval throwing. But maybe punched himself out, and the hard chin of Villanueva comes to
bow. Oh, and another overhand right.
A hard left hook by Sandoval to close the round. What a beautiful finish to a very good round. Ay. What a fight, guys. What a fight, ladies and gentlemen.
Villanueva.
As we go to commercial here to close out. As we see the corner of Villanueva continuing to plead for that knockout.
And he told him, hey, you have to knock him out.
You're down, yeah. He continues to tell him he's down. As we will hear the scorecards after 8 rounds from the WBC, as we had 8 rounds completed in this WBC Super Flyweight International title that's on the line here in Tijuana, Mexico.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds of boxing, and according to the WBC preliminary scorecards,
as we hear the scores.
Judge A scores it 78-75, Judge B 78-74, and Judge C 78-74. Damas y caballeros, después de 8 rounds, tenemos la puntuación preliminar de acuerdo al Consejo Mundial de Boxeo. El juez A 78-75, y los jueces B y C 78-74. All in favor, those a favor de Sandoval.
So all 3 judges have it for Victor Sandoval, 78-75 twice, and 78-74.
And I think that's the correct score, Chris. Sandoval has been showcasing his style here and staying smart.
Continuing to stay smart. Very good boxing exhibition from Victor Sandoval.
Like I said before, Villanueva needs to close off the ring because he's following Jackie Sandoval.
Yeah, he continues to follow. And not necessarily cutting off, but...
Oh, good right hand.
But to no avail, Sandoval keeps moving and throws a hard shot to the body and gives him a 1-2 for his trouble.
And that jab staying in his face. Beautiful jabs by Chucky Sandoval.
And again, you mentioned the jab. It stays there and it lands there.
It's what lets him stay at that distance and control the fight.
And you see a little bit of blood from the face of Kevin Villanueva. And again, what a beautiful body-head combination from Victor Sandoval. And a hard left hook there to finish that combination. And very good form does Victor Sandoval have.
He stayed busy the whole round.
And all Kevin Villanueva can do is just use his grit and strength to try and pressure his opponent. As we go into the 10th round, what would you say if you're in the corner of Sandoval that we see here?
Sandoval, keep doing what you're doing, man. Sticking, moving, you're boxing intelligently.
And for the corner of Kevin Villanueva, what would you recommend?
For Kevin Villanueva, he needs to go in there and needs to throw everything he can. This is the last round. You know you're losing. You have to close off the ring and get him in the corners and damage him. Just like his coaches are telling him right now, you need to go out there, you need to look for the knockout.
And the translation that I've never heard before is, what did you eat? He asked him, what did he eat? So maybe he ate a pound cake, because maybe his corner sees that he's a little bit too heavy. He's a little behind, and they're asking him for the knockout. But he's definitely behind. In my opinion, he's just heavy-footed here today.
Here we go. Can he get the knockout?
Oh! So a punch was landed, but
okay,
an obvious slip from Victor Sandoval. Not a punch that would have hurt anybody to the body that way, but an obvious slip. And a good call by the referee.
And those jabs of Chucky Sandoval staying in Villanueva's face. He's doing a fantastic job, Chris. He's moving around. Oh, and that's a good left hook. Moving around, attacking. Floating like a butterfly, stinging like a bee.
Stinging like a bee with that overhand right landed by Sandoval. Oh, and a hard right hand by Villanueva with a good comeback by Sandoval. And Villanueva, what a beard, ladies and gentlemen.
He's earned it, Chris. He has a golden chin.
He's got the golden chin. One day, you keep saying that, Dylan, it's going to stick. Eventually, it'll stick.
Somebody send me a plaque, please. Fantastic word by Sandoval. He's controlled the whole fight, Chris.
Yeah, in a moment where we thought that he might give in to the pressure of Villanueva, we're here in the 10th and final round, and he continues to show the exact same movement that he did in the first round.
And from this round, the way it looks, you would think that Sandoval was the one that was behind the scorecards, because he is staying busy.
The way he's fighting with urgency, you're correct.
And his corner did say, hey, you know, fight smart, but if you can knock him out, knock him out.
Yeah, that's very good advice, because at the end of the day, we're in the hurt business, you know? You want to see the knockout as a fan.
Yeah, and if you start to take your foot off the gas pedal, that gives Villanueva, you know, the opportunity to come in and knock you out. So, fantastic job by Sandoval in his corner.
As we get into the final minute of the final round, and the only chance.
Oh, good left hook by Sandoval.
And the only chance that Kevin Villanueva has is getting pretty far. As Sandoval landing hard shots to close the last minute. Not taking it easy. And a hard right hand by Sandoval. And he continues to show that beard to Sandoval.
He's going for the kill.
He's going for the kill.
Oh! Good combinations by Sandoval.
And
he
finishes. It's done. Victor Sandoval in the last 10 seconds. Victor Chucky Sandoval closes and finishes the fight. Despite that, Kevin Villanueva was never hurt in the fight. He gets hit hard and forces the referee to step in.
Man, I stayed quiet there for a little bit. I wasn't expecting that, man. He survived so much throughout the fight, but those last seconds, Sandoval went in, and he did exactly what his corner told him to do. Stay smart, but if you smell the kill, go for it.
Close the show, and close the show he did. What a finish, man. That was a sensational show of skills from Victor Chucky Sandoval. As we close and await the final, the final decision from our Pablo Flores. Man, I'm still excited. That was such a close, such a finish by the young 23-year-old Chucky Victor Sandoval. Man, he improves to 34 victories, 22 by knockout. After feeling comfortable being ahead on all three judges' scorecards after four rounds, being ahead on the judges' scorecards after eight rounds, he goes into the 10th and final round, takes the advice from his corner and steps on the gas and gets his opponent Kevin Villanueva out of there. And where they asked Kevin Villanueva to go out and get the knockout, Victor Sandoval goes out and gets the knockout himself. As we await the official announcement,
ladies and
from
gentlemen,
Pablo Flores,
referee Fernando Renteria steps in and calls a halt to this contest officially with a time of 2 minutes and 55 seconds in round number 10. Tenemos el tiempo oficial 2:55 del round número 10 cuando el referee Fernando Renteria detuvo las acciones. For your winner by the way of TKO victory, su vencedor por la vía del knockout técnico, he is the new interim WBC International Silver Flyweight Champion, el nuevo campeón interino CMB Internacional Plata de peso mosca, Puritito Fuerza Tijuas, Victor Chucky Sandoval.
Y también fuerte reconocimiento para su rival de Guasave, Sinaloa, el aguerrido Kevin Villanueva.
No te creía.
Dice, no te creía.
Como le dieron, de hecho, tanto yo como mi rival, nos sentimos muy felices. I knew I was going there to
knock out my opponent, as I knew he was trying to knock me out. We didn't see a knockout in the first or second round, but we kept looking.
Una guerra, lo decíamos, una pelea que llenó de emoción a la gente que estamos aquí en esta transmisión. Ya tienes el gran premio, el primer cinturón internacional, un cinturón que estaba vacante, el cinturón internacional plata del CMB, que significa todo.
Pues es un gran paso en mi carrera, para mí y mi equipo.
Well,
toda la gente que me ha estado apoyando, pues aquí está lo prometido. Prometimos que íbamos a ganar.
A veces no sean las cosas,
pero sacamos todo lo que traemos, la preparación que hicimos con mi equipo.
We prepared adequately. We did what we said we were going to do.
Esta victoria esta noche aquí en Tijuana.
Pues la verdad que ahora sí que pues hay que prepararnos fuertes, ¿no? Creo que este rival es muy fuerte, pero creo que el rival es un poco más duro, así que
the rival
hay que
prepararnos
más fuerte, creo que hay que trabajar más en el ring.
I need to work harder in the ring. The rival was tough in this fight. I'm going to keep getting better and staying prepared for the next fight. I want to thank my family, my wife, my son. My sponsorship has been supporting me throughout my whole career. This career isn't easy. Not everyone can step in the ring and do what we do. This is the toughest job there is in the world.
And Chucky, Victor Sandoval, getting the victory here in Tijuana, Baja California.
Acústicos o los núcleos del cerebro se le denomina como vértigo central. En consecuencia, el vértigo no es solo rotación, sino que puede presentarse como una sensación de tambaleo o caída hacia adelante o atrás, o de un movimiento de la tierra tipo temblor. Con frecuencia se acompaña de otros síntomas, como el impulso, sensación de que el cuerpo es arrojado o jalado en el espacio. Oscilopsia, ilusión visual de movimiento hacia atrás y adelante. Náuseas, vómito, diaforesis.
Esa última estuvo buena, ¿eh? Esa última.
Los síndromes de vértigo por lesiones periféricas son hidropesia endolinfática, síndrome de Menier, laberintitos, neuronitas, vestibular, vértigo traumático y vértigo de posición. Los síndromes de vértigo por lesiones centrales incluyen enfermedad vascular del tallo encefálico, malformaciones arteriovenosas, tumor del tallo encefálico y del cerebelo, esclerosis múltiple y migraña vertebrovascular. El reposo en cama puede ser la gravedad del vértigo agudo. En el vértigo crónico o reincidente, uno de los tratamientos más importantes es el ejercicio.
As we see on the screen, Willibaldo Garcia
de Copala Guerrero from Gorrara, from Copala Guerrero, Willibaldo Garcia. 10-3, Chris, with 5 KOs.
And he debuted very late in his career, 3 years ago.
Yeah, you know what? I had an opportunity to speak to Garcia before the fight. He actually did not have any amateur record.
Yeah, no amateur record. Just came in and debuted as a pro. That's props to him. You know, 27 years old when he had his first fight. No amateur record. Straight up professional. Just went in there. He knew he could do it. And so far, he's got a winning record, 10-3, you know, with no amateur boxing background.
5 KOs.
And you know what I like that he told me is that I asked him, what's your style? He said, I come forward and I leave it all in the ring. Those are his words. I leave it all in the ring.
Bajador, he told me.
As we see Alejandro Santiago,
El Peque,
on the screen. He debuted when he was 16, 24 years old now. So in 8 years, he's gotten 28 professional fights. And now today, he fights for the WBC Bantamweight International title. Here we go, Alejandro Santiago, we see on our screen here. As we see the defending Bantamweight WBC International title holder, Alejandro Santiago. As we take it to Pablo Flores for our initial announcement.
It's time to rock and roll with our main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing for the WBC International Bantamweight Championship. Damas y caballeros, este es el combate estelar de esta noche. 10 rounds por el Campeonato Internacional Peso Gallo del CMB. Sanctioned by the WBC President, sancionado por el CMB, Presidente Mauricio Sulaimán. Supervisor in attendance, el supervisor en turno, Carlos Labastida. Your three judges scoring this bout, el 10-point must system. Sus tres jueces, Sergio Lechuga, Jesús González y Julián Palombo. And your referee in charge of the action, su referee para este combate, el experimentado profesor Fernando Rentería. Ahora bien, damas y caballeros que nos siguen a través de la señal de PID, the best in boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are live from the most visited city, border city in the world. Estamos en vivo desde la ciudad, la frontera más visitada del mundo, Tijuana, Baja California, México. ¡Ajusten sus cinturones! Interested the fighter standing in the blue corner. He wears white with black and gold. He officially weighs in 118 pounds. Presentando ustedes en esquina azul, con pantalones y color blanco con negro y oro, con un peso de 53 kilos con 100 gramos. In 14 professional bouts, he stands with 10 victories, 3 defeats, 1 draw, and 5 of those victories coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 10 victorias, 3 derrotas, 1 empate y 5 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Representando a su natal Copala Guerrero. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the challenger, con ustedes, el retador, Willibaldo García! And his opponent across the ring, standing in the red corner, wearing black trunks with white and red. He officially weighs in the same, 118 pounds. y su rival en esquina roja, pantaloncillo color negro con rojo y blanco, con un peso de 53 kilos, 500 gramos. In 28 professional bouts, he stands with a record of 21 victories, 2 losses, 5 draws, and 11 of those victories coming by the fast way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 21 victorias, 2 derrotas, 5 empates, y 11 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the WBC International Bantamweight Champion, con ustedes, damas y caballeros, el campeón internacional de peso gallo del CMB, Puritito Tijuana, Baja California, Alex, el Peque Santiago. And now to give out the final instructions, con las indicaciones finales, your referee, Fernando Rentería. 10 rounds, 10 asaltos.
Los cabezazos, golpes en la nuca, en la espalda, abajo el cinturón, están prohibidos. Hagan una buena pelea, cuídense mucho. Suerte, gane el mejor.
Suerte que gane el mejor. Es el tercero sobre la superficie. Alex, el Peque Santiago.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, for the main event. The champion, Alejandro Santiago, versus Willibaldo García. And as advertised, Willibaldo García said that he just goes for it, and that's exactly what he does to initiate the contact.
Yeah, he went in there and started scrapping right off the bat.
And he lands a good overhand right on the top of the head of Santiago.
Good body shot by Santiago.
And that's what you need to do, is throw the body of an aggressive fighter.
And aggressive he is as he throws an overhand
very
right.
Very aggressive. These are hard shots thrown by Willibaldo García.
You can hear the thud over here at our table.
But Santiago showing why he's a champion, using good head movement, throwing straight shots, which is what is taught in the gym. Ring generalship.
And staying calm, Chris. The calmness in his face. It's a champion. This is what you expect in a champion to act like.
Well, good. I mean, 28 professional fights, you have to have that calmness to you. I'm pretty sure he's seen this style before, being from Tijuana. He's seen it in the gym at least, as we have aggressive fighters like Willibaldo García, a dime a dozen. As there's a little bit of a red abrasion on the right brow of Santiago.
Yeah, García is not letting off the gas pedal.
He does not. García is aggressive. I like the style, landing a good jab there. I enjoy all aspects of the boxing game. I particularly like the aggressiveness, though, of Willibaldo García. Maybe because I admire it, because it's hard for me to do. I couldn't do it in my professional boxing career. I was more of a boxer.
Oh, good overhands. Good overhand rights by García.
And look at the grimace on García's face. He's just angry. He wants to hit something. He wants to hit somebody. He wants to take Santiago out.
He looks like somebody stepped on his shoes before going on there, Chris.
Oh! And a hard right hand.
You know what? That's what you need to do. You're going up against the champion. You tell him, I'm not afraid of you. Let's go.
Definitely, definitely. But Santiago did the right thing there. He planted his feet, and he landed a hard right hand to the face of García. But García just took it, ate it, and kept coming.
Good round by García.
Good round by both fighters. Good show of boxing. Good show of boxing by Santiago. Good show of aggression.
Completamente de acuerdo.
No te tomen una decisión así porque le gustó el otro. ¿Entendiste? Golpealo a la cabeza. ¿Todo bien?
He tenido que aguantar mucho. Es largo, le tengo que pegar para acá.
Ahí está, dice, fuera Seconds, el tercero sobre la superficie. Aquí en Tijuana, después de sorprender Willy Baldo a Checo Santiago en el primer episodio.
Here we go, round two.
And see if we continue to see the aggression from Willy Baldo as advertised.
This is a 10-round fight, Chris. It's a 10-round fight. And to start off, at 100, like Garcia did, it's going to be tough to keep that pace up. Now we're going to see the intelligence of Santiago making adjustments to the style that Garcia is bringing to the table. As Garcia keeps that pressure on Santiago with those hard shots. And every one of his shots, Chris,
are hard.
Yeah, those are hard
those
shots.
Those are hard shots, and the aggression is...
It's like he's throwing rocks with every punch.
And I say it again, the expression on Willy Baldo Garcia's face is just priceless, man. He's angry. He wants to hurt somebody.
Who did this kid wrong before he got into this ring?
I don't want to be the guy to ask him. And continued aggression, but Santiago keeping calm, collected, using good movement.
And it's those overhand rights that keep landing, Chris. And they throw Santiago off.
One right there.
Oh, good jab by Santiago.
Whoa! What a right hand and left hook.
Good counters by Santiago.
Got the attention of Willy Baldo Garcia, but he says, no, you did not hurt me, and he continues to throw hard shots.
Oh, and a good straight right by Santiago.
Oh, and a hard left hook there by Garcia. So let me touch on the fact that comparison. This right here is the bantamweight version of Ricardo Mayorga. Tell me that I'm wrong.
Oh, that body shot, man. Yes,
that hard body shot.
You are completely correct.
This is Ricardo Mayorga mini with a six pack because he took that. He ate that body shot. Mayorga never took body shots well. And this was a hard body shot thrown by Santiago. Willy Baldo Garcia took it and continues to truck forward.
Oh, man.
Oh, and a hard left hook by Garcia and continues to show that aggression. Mini Ricardo Mayorga. Willy Baldo Garcia, I went ahead and branded him with his very own nickname.
Él siempre baja la esta. Cuando ya veas cruces, remata la cabeza.
He's always dropping his guard. So you need to get him one, two, and look for the body.
Pero es que te tardas. No te tardes.
Garcia says, I'm doing that.
Keep making changes short. You're doing everything perfect. Keep throwing the uppercut and finish to the top. His corner asking for two or three punches, combination. How do you feel his punch? Normal, he said.
Normal. And what we have to take into account as well, Chris, is that Garcia is throwing consistent hard punches, but we're only on round two.
Round three. Yeah, we only went through two rounds. That we're both on the same page.
see how long he can keep this aggressive style for. And one thing that I like from Santiago's corner, they asked him, how does he hit? And he responded fine, like he, like nothing overwhelming, I assume that response meant.
And out of 14 fights that he has so far, he has 5 knockouts. So he can catch him with a jab, though.
That continued aggression, man. It's.
I don't think anybody told Villalobos Garcia.
One, two by Garcia.
I don't think anybody told him that. Yeah, I don't think anybody told him this is a boxing match. He looks like he's at a bar fight right now.
I mean, it's hard to get ready for a style like this. I can't imagine Santiago knowing that this was the style that Garcia was going to bring.
You know what? It reminds me of Maidana. You know how he just went in there and just started making it ugly, making it a brawl.
Yeah, I'd like to say that Maidana had a little bit more class.
I'm comparing him to a bar fight, so I would say, yeah.
Still say Ricardo Mayorga. Willibaldo, Mini, Ricardo Mayorga Jr. And he continues to come forward, throwing with no style necessarily. Like you said, just a bar fight, but he lands a good short hook on the chin of Santiago. Santiago doing very well to avoid those shots from Garcia. Nothing really seemed to faze Santiago, and he goes and throws to the body of Garcia. And good defensive tactics from Alejandro Santiago. Very good boxing movements.
And you know what I'm noticing from Garcia is that he's throwing those hard punches, Chris, but he's not sitting down on them so much.
And a hard right hand there. Santiago closes the distance. Seems like it didn't faze him too much, but the shot was landed nonetheless.
Good jab work by Santiago.
Oh. And good movement, man. This guy is very good at evading shots, despite the fact that Willibaldo Garcia is throwing weird and reckless shots. Santiago doing a good job of evading.
Now the question is, how long can he keep that up?
The pace that Garcia is throwing?
Garcia, how long can he keep throwing those hard punches?
Porque te va a dar presión. No quiero que te canse nada más que lo estés cargando, ¿ok? Dale la vuelta y mételo, pero con presión a golpe, ¿ok?
The corner of Santiago asking him to continue to move and don't carry Garcia's weight on his back. It's going to wear him down, they're saying.
There's a couple of smart tactics that Santiago's been using. When he wraps up, he's holding on to Willibaldo Garcia's hands, and as Garcia's trying to pull out, that gets you tired as time goes on.
Yeah, it's definitely harder to wrestle than it is to shoot your shots. Ooh, and a hard 1-2 by Garcia. This time having some success with those straight shots.
Oh!
Ruled a slip by the ref, rightfully so. Ooh, and a hard body shot there by Santiago. And it does not deter Garcia's tenacity to come forward and just sling shots with no style necessarily. maybe only the bar fight style.
And a
slip there by Santiago. Garcia taking over. Taking advantage, landing a hard over right overhand right, and he lands it again. Santiago trying to do the Mayweather to no avail there, as Garcia's overhand right landed on the top of his head, and he feels it. He knows he hurt him, or maybe just got his attention, not necessarily hurt him.
And Villalobos Garcia is boxing, wrestling. He's doing everything in there. That's what you got to do against a champion. Tell him I'm not afraid.
Ooh,
I'm coming for what's yours.
Right hand left.
Oh,
maybe the most success that Garcia has had here in the fourth round, after being outboxed in the first three rounds, having success with that warlike style that he brings, not taking no for an answer, throwing unconventional shots. Finally having success is Garcia.
You know, Santiago is not using a lot of feints. Villalobos Garcia is coming forward. You know he's coming forward. He's throwing everything at you. Do a little bit of feints. Taunt him.
To get him to pause slightly, right, so you could land your own shots.
Or get him to shoot and counter him.
And look at the rocks pretty much that he's throwing. That's the type of style I would describe Garcia. Just rock slinging. Look at that.
Oh.
Hard left hook and right hand. Wow, what a finish to the fourth round. And I've got to say that this has been the first round that I have given to Garcia, landing brutal shots to the head of Santiago. As they're asking him to keep his distance.
It's his defense. He doesn't want to fight. Saying he hasn't done anything to you, but you need to throw more punches. Breathe, recover. Everything you're throwing, he's catching.
They want three or four punches. They want combinations from Santiago. And here we go for the fifth round. After four rounds completed, we can expect the judges' scorecards. I gave Garcia the very first round of the fight, being the fourth, after being dominated by Santiago through the first three.
As we see Garcia keeping that pressure, that tough, heavy pressure on Santiago.
Ooh.
Oh.
And the right uppercut just missed. As we hear the scorecards.
De acuerdo al CMB, y después de cuatro rounds tenemos las calificaciones preliminares. Judge A scores it 39-37. El juez A 39-37. Judge B and Judge C have the same scores of 38-38. El juez B y el C coinciden en números 38-38. En favor, de Santiago.
So one judge has it 39-37 for Santiago, and the other two judges have it 38-38, a draw. And I could definitely see that, considering the aggression that Garcia is putting on here. And he continues to just put aggression. Sooner or later, Alejandro Santiago might just get tired of it and fall to it.
And, you know, it doesn't let you think. You can't put your game plan when somebody's keeping that pressure on you. You know, like Mike Tyson said, everybody has a game plan until they get punched in the face, and right now Santiago is definitely getting punched in the face. Garcia has not stopped with that pressure from the first round. Oh, but a good left hook by Santiago.
And it has to wear on Santiago, the fact that Garcia keeps coming, and it has to do something to your morale. The fact that you hit this guy with everything but the kitchen sink and Garcia keeps coming.
And in these exchanges, we see Santiago kind of breathing, kind of taking it slow, but Garcia is still with that mug, mean face. Just going for causing pain.
He's
causing
an angry fighter as we come to the last 10 seconds, and it seems as though
fly out.
I thought he got hurt a little bit, but no, it's just the extra aggression that he wanted to add to it. And it was the mouthpiece of Garcia that fell to the ground. And maybe it just made him a little angry.
Yeah, he didn't care.
Yeah, he didn't care. He continued to throw punches.
Así es que no necesitas de las tarjetas. Tienes que noquear a ese muchacho.
You don't need the cards. You need to knock that guy out.
Seconds out as we see Santiago still on his stool taking his time.
He's been doing that the last couple of rounds,
maybe getting that little extra breather.
Could be from the experience he has.
Definitely the experience, but I see Willibaldo Garcia just kind of running downhill, man. He's not getting tired. He's throwing strong shots. He's an aggressive fighter.
Like I mentioned before, Santiago is not using a lot of feints, man. Just, you know, bait him in. You know he's coming forward. Do a little feint. Have him commit to his punches and counter him. Doing a good job using the ring.
And he turns to southpaw for the first time in the fight. See if it comes. And it's starting to see like Alejandro Santiago starting to feel that pressure, holding on a little bit more than he was in the first few rounds.
It has to be frustrating. This, the pressure Garcia is putting on him is no joke.
And maybe frustrating him a little bit.
You see a jab land from Garcia, follows it up with the right hand.
And Willibaldo Garcia has his opponent on the ropes with not much response. And it might be another round that he takes away. And a hard left hook landed by Garcia there. And Santiago quickly turns his opponent around and goes to the body there. Does not face Garcia. Garcia keeps trucking forward with the aggressiveness. Short little uppercut there. Oh! And a hard!
Good right. Oh!
And they trade right hands there at the end of the round. Excuse me, at the end of the first
2 minutes of the sixth round.
I'm becoming a fan here. I'm getting excited. And losing focus here, but those were good, hard shots landed by both fighters.
Oh, and a good combination by Santiago.
Both throwing combinations as opposed to Santiago pity-patting and pop-shotting Garcia. He's now throwing combinations, what they asked in his corner. But Garcia keeps coming forward.
Oh, and good jab by Santiago.
Throwing combinations. Good right hand landed by Santiago. Good 1-2 again. The aggression by Garcia is relentless.
Pressure. does not stop.
As we approach the final 10 seconds, as I got ahead of myself earlier. Wow. What a close to the sixth round of a scheduled 10.
Ponga al contrario, okay? Vamos a subir el ritmo. Cada que entra él así, mira, entra con
las
manos así,
le vas a
cabecear a la derecha y lo vas a enganchar por dentro.
Every time
una vez que se está dentro,
he comes over this way, you lean over to your right and throw to the body.
You saw what I saw. You saw what I told you. If you don't knock him out, you're not going to win. And if the other rounds they didn't give to you, this round was real even. No, you need to pressure him. He's not throwing at you. He's just hugging.
Just like you know how to do it. Do it solid. Very good fight. Six rounds in the books for the WBC Bantamweight International title.
Oh!
And in the corner of Willibaldo Garcia, what they've been telling him, keep throwing shots because you need a knockout. So they're not waiting for the ninth and the tenth round to tell him he needs a knockout. They've been telling him he needs a knockout since the fourth or fifth round.
And that's the right mentality for any boxer. It doesn't matter what kind of style you have. You never leave it up to the judges because you never know what the judges are seeing. And I'm going to be honest with you, Chris. I didn't expect Garcia to keep this pace and to keep the power shots coming so far into the fight.
Yeah, he's in shape. He's Ricardo Mayorga 2.0. It's going to stick.
Oh.
And we see some aggression.
Oh,
wow.
Good overhand right by Garcia. Does not. He's on him.
Yeah, it does not stop with that aggression. We continue to see that aggression. With good shots, good combinations, throwing, see how long Santiago can keep his opponent off of him as he was doing in the beginning rounds, boxing so beautifully.
Good left hook by Santiago there. Santiago's falling into Garcia's game plan. This is a fight that Garcia wants.
Oh, and a hard left hook landed by Santiago. Garcia responds with the overhand right.
Good body shot by Santiago.
That's what I feel that Santiago needs to
do.
Slow down his opponent.
Good left hook by Garcia. Has a champion on the ropes, Chris.
He has the champion on the ropes. A smart champion turns him around. Puts his opponent on the ropes, but really can't keep him there. Has to keep backpedaling. Look at those.
Oh.
Look at those shots thrown by Garcia. Every shot is hard.
This kid doesn't stop. Doesn't stop. And it's a different thing than a Terminator because Pinto was walking through the punches. This kid is walking forward, throwing hard shots,
throwing combinations. Wow!
Oh.
Hard right hand landed on the head of Santiago.
Good uppercut by Santiago, though. As he works off the rope.
Oh! And a brutal exchange from both fighters. As we come to the close of the seventh round, Garcia continues to throw and throw. He is not trying to put it in the hands of the judges.
And as he gets back to the corner, they tell him, hey, your opponent is tired. Keep looking for that knockout.
Hazlo, ¿ok? Okay. Suéltese, mijo. Pero chacal, ¿ok? Oh. Y sólido, ¿ok? Vamos.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, round number eight, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, round number eight, Willibaldo Garcia continuing to put on the pressure on Santiago. The beautiful boxing of Santiago, the hard pressure from Garcia.
The fuel tank this kid has to be able to maintain that. I believe that was a, was it a head clutch?
And the first head clash of the fight, considering Willibaldo Garcia continued to lead with his head. Surprising that this is the first headbutt of the matchup.
Oh, right back to the hard shots for Garcia. Back to the pressure. Good combination.
Ooh, good
by Santiago.
Combination, yes. Very good boxing skills, but it's hard to keep this guy off. You look at him, and he's telling him, come on, come at me, come at me. So this is going to be a difficult way to score the fight, because the last few rounds, Santiago hasn't been doing as much pop shotting as he did in the beginning round. And Garcia has not stopped what he's been doing. He's been doing the exact same thing.
And it's been working for him, Chris. Santiago has not been able to make adjustments to the style and the pressure that Garcia has put in front of him.
Wow, there you go. Hard left hook by Garcia. And a hard combination left hook and right uppercut by Santiago. No matter what, Willibaldo Garcia is going to make some fans here tonight with that style. Everybody's going to want to see this kid again.
He comes in here to fight, Chris.
Wow, continues to throw hard shots. We're in the eighth round, Dylan, and still throwing like it's the first round.
Yeah, I looked over, round eight. Like I said, the gas tank on this kid. Oh, good combination by Santiago.
And Santiago musters a combination. Willibaldo Garcia continues to just drive forward with that aggression. Look at that. And when I interviewed him, he said, I come forward. I go forward strong and I leave it all in the ring. And typically, I sit there and it just, okay, not necessarily take a fighter's word for it, because like you said earlier, Mike Tyson said, everybody has a plan until you get punched in the face. This guy has been punched in the face numerous times and the game plan does not change.
Willy, no vas ganando, vas perdiendo toda la pelea. Vas a perder.
You're not winning right now. You're losing the fight. Because you're not fighting.
Pues no, porque él te abraza.
No, because when you get close,
pues
he's hugging you.
Te lo estoy diciendo, ¿eh? Yo no
I've
sé
been
por
telling
chingado,
you.
No te lanzas a noquear a ese muchacho.
I don't know why you don't go out there and knock this kid out. He's hugging you. He's doing what he needs to.
There you are. You know how to make these combinations.
¿Qué round sigue? ¿Qué round es?
What round is?
Es el momento de subirle. No quiero que nos vayan a dar
this is the moment to turn it up. We don't want a bad decision. We have two rounds left. We have to close. We need an explosion. 3-4 punches and move. And Willibaldo Garcia has done exactly what he said he was going to do and leave it all in the ring as he lands a hard body shot
on Santiago as Santiago turns him and continues to try to box him. And what they said in the corner is that all he's doing is hugging you. And right now Santiago proved it correct. And what a furious pace by Garcia. And a hard hook by Santiago does not deter Garcia. Keeps charging forward.
It's like a mad bull, Garcia. Oh, just missed with that uppercut. It's a hard, tough, grinding fight that Garcia is bringing to the table.
Yeah, but for both fighters, it's a very grinding fight. Gonna see what the judges prefer here,
and we're gonna hear that. I believe
we're about to hear the scorecards from the WBC.
Oh, good exchange of punches there,
and good jab, good defense by Santiago. One of my favorite attributes of Garcia is that angry face that he puts on as he punches. Look at that anger, the anger in his eyes as he throws combinations to the head and to the body of Santiago. Santiago doing a good job of defending.
Oh, and that's a good combination by Santiago. Little retaliation
from the aggression of Garcia. And Garcia turns southpaw as we hear the scores.
According to the WBC preliminary scores, we have the following. Después de 8 rounds, y de acuerdo al CMB, tenemos las siguientes tarjetas preliminares. Judge A, el juez A, scores at 77-76. Judge B, 76-76. And Judge C, el juez C, 77-75
for Santiago. So we have two scorecards for Santiago. We have one has it even at 76-76. So this fight, very close, still up in the air in the final two rounds. 77-76 for Santiago, 77-75. As we go to the corner of what Santiago's corner has to say. They're asking for him to leave it all in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is round number 10. Your final round.
As we come to our final round.
Good jab started off from Santiago.
A recognized foul by Santiago on Garcia, but the toughness of Garcia doesn't even take even 10 seconds. And Garcia does not let Santiago hold exactly what they told him in his corner. Do not let your opponent hold you. All he wants to do is hold you. That may not be the case, but that's what they're saying in the corner of Garcia.
Santiago doing a good job of boxing back to his lateral movement.
Santiago knows he's winning the fight. He has to stay smart here.
Wow, what a 1-2 there by Santiago. Garcia takes it again and does not want to be held. And going for the knockout like instructed by his corner. Landing to the head and to the body of Santiago. Not with the best style, but necessarily landing. He's landing.
This is what a contender should do. You know you're losing. You have the final round. Do not let the champion grab you. You know, go there and
do
put
not
your
let
fist
him
to face
on the lead.
Exactly.
Ooh, and a hard hook by Garcia,
and a good overhand right by Garcia.
Oh. Wow, what a shot! But it also seems like Garcia was the one to get hurt by Santiago, that little inside right hand. And I think Santiago smells it. And Santiago doing a very good job of turning his fighter opponent into the corner and landing quick little short shots there.
Yeah, we see Santiago putting on the pressure now.
Ooh, and a hard 1-2 by Santiago. Ooh, do not turn your back on your opponent. Protect yourself at all times. And there's a cut on the left eye of Santiago. It was a hard headbutt. And it seems as though Santiago thinks it was intentional by the stare of death that he gave Garcia in that corner, and he's mad. As we come to the last 10 seconds of this 10th and final round. And Santiago knows he won as he climbs into the neutral corner. And for the limited fans that we have here, pretty much the production crew, he puts out his hands in victory.
Good fight as Santiago's corner takes a look at the cut he got on the final round.
And it doesn't seem as though it's a very small cut. Nothing crazy. As they say in the corner of Garcia, that they're not going to give you the fight. I feel you won, but they're not going to give it to you. Why didn't you knock him out? And that's a pretty easy statement to say as a cornerman. Like, why didn't you, or anybody, why didn't you knock him out? Okay. He tried. I think Garcia tried.
Throughout the whole fight, he was trying to do that.
He was trying, man.
And you know what? I don't know about that 75 to 77 scorecard. I really didn't see any round that was 77. Or that was a 10-8 round for Santiago.
I didn't either. I mean, the judges may have seen something. I didn't. You know, definitely just clear victories for either fighter, but not a landslide 10-8 round.
Yeah.
But we'll see. And a very good way to close the main event, our four fight card, brought to you by Paco Presents Global Sports Streaming, ladies and gentlemen.
A four fight card. And it brought this much excitement.
It brought a lot of excitement. Very good fight. And I have to once again give props to Baco Presents Promotions, and he is a student of Hall of Famer Don War a Week Charging. I have to repeat my message, the fact that Paco Presents, Paco Damian, learned from the best. Don, War a Week Charging. Hall of Famer, ladies and gentlemen. Hall of Fame promoter, as we go to Pablo Flores for the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we now go to the judges' scorecards. Después de 10 rounds de combate, nos vamos con las tarjetas de los jueces. No sin antes, un fuerte, fuerte aplauso para Willibaldo García y el Peque Sandrero por este gran combate. Judge, el juez Julián Palomo, he scores it 97-94, 97-94. El juez, Judge Sergio Lechuga, scores it 96-94, 96-94. And Judge, el juez Jesús González, has it 95-95 even, 95-95. For your winner by the way of majority decision, su vencedor por la vía de la decisión mayoritaria. And still the WBC International Bantamweight Champion, au campeón internacional peso gallo del CMB, Puritito Tijuana, Alex El Peque Santiago.
And we get a majority decision for Santiago, defends his championship belt, on to bigger and better things. Hopefully a world title is in order, as we see the disappointment there in Garcia.
And I can't blame him. He left his heart in that ring, Chris, and honestly it could have gone either way. I would have been happy with the draw.
He poured his heart and soul into that fight, man.
Oh, yeah, man. Rematch, man. Let me see a rematch.
Maybe a rematch. You know what, man? No matter what, I want to see Willibaldo Garcia fight again. Santiago did his work. He fought like a champion. And you see some sportsmanlike conduct there from Santiago.
And
y de esta manera llegamos al fin de esta velada boxística. Queremos agradecer a todos los patrocinadores a nombre de Paco Presents, Fábrica de Campeones. Y nos estamos viendo en Noche de Box número 30 próximamente. Despedimos de ustedes.
Señor tu Dios, amarás a tu prójimo como a ti mismo. Yo te mando hoy que ames a Jehová tu Dios. Maridos, amados, a vuestra mujer siempre en la flor del mundo.
Great fight by both boxers here, as we have Santiago joining our co-commentator here. I had never seen him fight before. I knew he was going to be a tough fight, coming forward, and that's what he did. It was a real dirty fight. He was coming forward, no clean punches, using headbutts. Real dirty fighter. All the punches he was throwing at me, they were hitting the air. He was missing. There was no moment where he actually did damage on me. It may look like it on my face, but not really.
You never got frustrated?
I felt comfortable. I knew what his game plan was going to do. I knew he was going to lead with the head. And I started to feel a little desperate when I couldn't get him off me. So I tried using my jab to get a little bit of distance. But all the punches he landed on me, I mean, I hit him with I blocked him with my shoulder, moving my head. I feel like I've won. I feel like I won clean.
Would you give him the rematch?
Of course I would give him a rematch. But he needs to fix the dirty style that he uses. There's a lot of headbutts.
Maybe this will be beneficial if you ever face a fighter like this.
Yeah, he was coming in forward. He was putting a lot of pressure. We knew that's what he was going to do. Throwing a lot of overhand punches. But I didn't expect the elbows, the headbutts. I was expecting a clean fight.
So at the end of the fight, we saw some frustration. He threw a punch that may have been illegal, but you're still the champion. And what's next in your next fight?
I had to go back to the gym, keep working, get to the top. Next year, I hope to get a bigger opportunity with what I showed in this fight. Here in boxing, we're all warriors.
WBC champion, Alejandro Santiago.
Thank you, everyone at home, for joining us for these four fantastic fights. We predicted fireworks, Chris. They got them.
Very good fights. Paco Presents Global Sports Streaming. Thank you guys very much for joining us here tonight. On behalf of Dylan El Rey Miranda, I'm Chris Martin. Everybody have a good night.